In spite of mammoth inventions and discoveries of mankind, we have not been able to fully grasp the duality of love and lust in human relationships.
The sixth book launch chilo amra onar theke jene nebo idea. Welcome sir, welcome to Phil Gossi.
Thank you.
You have been a popular writer and you have a huge fan, you have a huge fan base. What we want to know, the thought behind this sixth book?
Actually, I was invited to the Tata Literary Steam meet in January 2020, and I was a part of the discussion Dark Side of the Mind on the opening day, and I spent the whole day at the Tata Literary Steam meet, and I listened to various sessions, I met various interesting people, I also participated in my session, and thereafter there was a dinner at the Taj Bengal for authors. So while I was driving back home, I thought that how I will explain all these thoughts to my daughter. So that is how this first part of the book came into being. And normally in winters I write poetry, so 20 poems I have written in March, and the poems were basically each poem was a story by itself, where the poet and the alter ego and his alter ego fights for a space. And I found certain kind of similarities between the prose and the poetry, because of which they were combined into this slim and elegant book.
Which saw the audio visual?
This audio visual is from my first book.
Ballads.
Okay. Yeah, ballads from my first book, Pentacles, which was published in 2010. And these are very popular ballads, because of which the audio visuals were created.
It was a fabulous thing. My question is that ballads is, now we can say it's kind of a dying art. Okay, not many people are listening to it. Although we enjoying, and we being coming from the literary background, okay, we enjoy it.
Well, it is for the authors and the writers to put life into various kinds of arts which are dying, because ballads have a capability to tell stories, as you have seen. And Shostika asked a very relevant question, to which I have no ready answer. But the fact is, they do ask questions, and I do think ballads have a way of their own. Of course, ballads, speaking ballads, telling ballads is an ancient art. But I think, I don't know whether these ballads by itself can run on their own, but they have been popular by itself.
I think next turn with a few questions. Okay, as she was asking also, we do want to know whether we will get a part of it, or we'll get to know the answers.
You can't get any answer. You see, the job of a writer is to puncture the holy curtain, ask questions. Answers have to be found by the audience.
So you are making us, guessing ourselves the questions, like short story writers.
Yeah.
Our next question that we want to ask, how much this pandemic has changed you, your mindset, being a writer?
Well, the pandemic, in fact, initially, midway there was some gloom in it, but now I have also finished my seventh book, alright. Yesterday I signed my contract for the seventh book, which is Fractured Mosaic, and it will be hitting the markets in February 2021. So I'm a very productive person. I'm a professional engineer, I'm a senior engineering professional, so I'm doing my engineering work, writing on technical stuff, participating in webinars on management and technical things, critical thinking, and also doing my literary stuff. Yeah, I'm doing all the things all the time. I keep myself busy, from 9 a.m. till 9 p.m. in the night.
I guess that's the motive, that as you see, the Japanese also say, like, keep yourself busy and you will live a long life. The last question, what would you say the young writers, the upcoming writers, to in this era where everything is become digitalization, and you have made it, like, not being going to digitalization, or you have asked us to come here and to be here, it's a totally different experience.
It's a kind of a celebration, you see. I mean, if we all join together, I think it's a celebration of life. That was the motive behind it, and to break the monotony of doing everything online. I don't know. I mean, I don't know whether these things would be good or bad. I can't say. But yeah, this was a way to get the monotony breaking. That was the.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
I would like to really know the last answer, not the first two, because it's quite typical of men to leave women like that. But I would really like to know the last answer, as in why did. I think it's also a story of women not asking for validation from other people or from the society and standing up and fighting their own battle. That is very important, and given what this year has been like, 2020, and we have heard so much of domestic violence cases and things going wrong in everybody's house. Stories like this inspire you to do the right thing for yourself and stand up for yourself and your life worth living. But then also, Jerome, we want to go to the hospital.
And one last question about this book reading session. We generally don't find book reading session like this way. How was your evening? What do you have to say on this one?
I felt very good coming out. That is predominantly the most, I think, amazing thing that has happened this year, because I've been working at a stretch, but you're working, you're going and getting ready and making other lives. I have not really done a little bit of shadow to come out.